Hey, it's Jarren. I'm currently testing out a new keyboard. It's actually a stenography keyboard. It's called the Uni, and it is very unusual compared to normal keyboards. It's not any of the weird, like, keyboard formats like Dvorak or whatever. It's not QWERTY. It's called steno or stenography, and it's a type of typing where you actually press down multiple keys at once, and that combination is the thing that spells the word. So it's actually really interesting, but there's a really big learning curve. It's not just you type it and you get it. You have to kind of memorize key combinations and sounds of words in order to get the actual word that you're looking for. So there are a bunch of different dictionaries, and you can add words to dictionaries. But the interesting thing is, the cool payoff is the fact that you can learn to type at speeds the equal to or faster to how fast people talk. For the most part, this has been reserved to like courtrooms. So people in courtrooms would use these devices, and they still do, to transcribe conversations. That's really where it started. And there's now a hobbyist community. I think it's a perfect time to jump in. People are starting to get interested in it, and I am too. So I think it's going to be a really cool opportunity for me to learn a new skill and hopefully type twice as fast as I normally do. I currently type on a QWERTY keyboard at 55 words per minute, which is terrible. And if I could even improve that to 100 words per minute, I could type twice as fast. That means I could get information out of my head onto a computer twice as fast. Although to get to that point is going to take some time. I'm looking at probably 6 months to a couple of years just to get up to speed. And I think it will be worthwhile. I think the 2 years from now me will thank me for what I'm doing today. I think it's a really cool opportunity to bring people along on a journey. I am going to learn stenography here, and I'm going to share my process with you and the things that I'm learning. And in the meantime, I'm going to get better. So I'm starting out right now. I am a complete amateur. I have spent a couple of minutes on QWERTY, and then I am just jumping into the deep end. Okay, so I am going to get started here. I have, of course, my normal keyboard, and then I also have the Uni as well. I am opening Plover, and I'm going to try and figure out how to get this connected. I just restarted it, and I'll go to Configure. Oh, it says Keyboard. I don't see in this list the Uni in Machine. It doesn't show that. It says Gemini, Keyboard, Passport, Procat. I will have to look for something else. So maybe I just Google how to connect Uni to Plover. Machine, Gemini PR. There we go. Click the button that says scan. Okay, let's go in here. Machine, Gemini. So I need port COM1. I don't see COM1 showing. It says connected. Oh, okay. So start typing. Well, I guess let's try. I don't know what any of the letters are either. So I'm gonna have to learn all of this. So these are the two middle ones, I'm assuming. So that means I'm starting here. So it's this one, and... oh, no, wait, I gotta activate it. Toggle output. Okay, here we go. No, I'm still not working. Or USB modem on a Mac. Okay, here we go. So USB modem. I do see a couple of them. Click apply. Apply that. Ah, we got it. Okay. Nice. So it is now connected and functioning. Okay, and I do not have this image memorized. I'm just gonna drag it to my desktop and open it so I can actually compare it to it so I can see it. Okay, well, this is it. I have no clue how to use this paper tape thing. I have it pulled up here, and I have absolutely no idea how to use it, so I'm going to just ignore it for now. I know it's like just showing me the combinations of what I'm pressing, but I think people like look at them and they can like critique their work. They're like, oh, I messed up here. I don't really understand how that would work yet. Okay, and so now I just press. Ha, I got it. Okay. Was her. Has. Part. Whoops. So I know I have to press these two middle, the four middle ones are like delete or backspace technically, or alternate if I press them with key combination. I'm so excited to like learn the different dictionaries and everything as well. So this one is P and then U down here and then T put. Whoops. What did I do wrong? Oh, it's over this one because these four are centered. Pout, whoops, okay. So currently I'm at two words per minute. It's nice that I can kind of hold, whoops, so I can kind of get an idea of how long it, like I can lock one in. So if I'm confident that's a W, confident that's an A, confident that's an R, war. So that's where it's useful to critique, because I was supposed to type K-E-P-T and I accidentally typed K-E-F-L because I was off on the right side a little bit. I'll get a better keyboard. I got to get a better keyboard view at some point in time because I could see how that's like super, super helpful to see based off of what's happening. Top, nope. Top, nope. Top, nope. Dang. Top. Ah, nice. Hot. Nice. Okay, three words per minute. Great. Spot. Nope. What did I do there? I did shot. Oh, because I keep... Okay. I need something, a marker. I'm just going to tape for a minute over the four keys so I remember that they're not part of my group. I understand, I think if you're like really used to the setup, you already know what the letters are. I have no clue what these letters are at this point in time. So I think that is a shortcoming for me because I don't have anything to really compare it to. I thought about like, I could maybe draw the letters on to really remember. Although I know ideally I shouldn't be looking at it for very long. Like I shouldn't look down, I think. So I guess let me actually practice not looking down. Whew, that's hard. Okay. I look down. H A T hat. H U R. I look down. T. Whoops. H U R T. Hurt. S. So what did I do? I did H-A, so I accidentally added an A at the last one. I keep always wanting to press down with my left thumb, so I gotta be careful. I only press down when it's there. So S-A-L-T, salt. I almost pushed it again. I want to push down two letters with my left hand, and I shouldn't be doing that. Unless, like in this situation, so it's P-O, and then this one's RT, port. Oh, I accidentally pressed the... I pressed the O. There we go. Oh, I accidentally pressed the E. I always press... I just want to press both vowels for some reason. Or like both thumbs at the same time. Typically, it seems like I'm only really pressing one thumb at a time. At least right now. I know that's not always the case. But that especially for some of these shorter letters or shorter words. I pressed. See, that's exactly it. I at least I'm able to really quickly, like, I'm, well, kind of quickly able to realize what I've done wrong, which is press two vowels at the same time instead of just one. I'm going to also try and start figuring out the words from the letters. It'd be actually very interesting to see the letters first and then I'd guess the word. I feel like that would help me learn the dictionary a little bit better. SP, I'm sure that's a setting on this page. It looks like it probably is. S-P-U-R. Whoops. S. Oh, I was over too far. I pressed the number one. I know these two are numbers. And I guess there's traditionally like a number row at the top, which these don't have. And I don't really care about tradition too much. So if this is more efficient, then I'll stick with this and I'll learn this. I can't really imagine learning on a different device at this point in time. I just need to get it down on one. Well, that was day one, and I am excited to see where I go from here. I think there's a lot of opportunity, and I can already feel myself starting to remember some of the key combinations, and I'm going to start practicing writing down the keyboard and then trying to draw on those key names from memory. Like, where is the K, where is the T, things like that. I think that would help a lot, just building that memory so I don't look at the keyboard. Anyway, if you enjoyed, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.